Hello, in this video we will touch how to make responsive your interface using multithread with TaskAway in C#. TaskAway was incorporated to C# in version 6 with Visual Studio 2015. This second instruction simplifies how to manage thread in our program. Let's begin with a comparison of the example program without multithread and another using TaskAway. Let's begin with this simpler program example without multithread. This is a normal program with a clip button here, event, and we simulate here a long task that is 10 seconds. To simulate what happened is when the thread found a part of the program that is very delayed. This is no asynchronic way, that's what we are testing here. If you see here, this button, this is the event for this button. And when we're running, we see that the interface is complete freezing after this thread finish. And now it's finished, and then the interface recover its responsivity. Let's see a little more deep the example we saw. When we use a synchronic code, all the processes happen in the same thread. In the case of window application, the same as user interface thread. Then, if a longer operation is in progress, the user interface is freezing. In the example, when we click the button begin long task, the event triggers the associated procedure and the code is running sequentially until rest thread slit operation. In our case, this simulates a long time operation. The thread stops to execute, and when the operation finalizes, the execution continues to the end of the procedure, and the control is returned to the program to be able to execute other events. For that, we saw in the demonstration that the interface does not respond. Now, let's see the same example, but now we're using a wait task to create asynchronous mechanisms to operate with the long task here. This is our asynchronous method. Here we simulate a delay for 10 seconds using the property of this task delayed. That's made that this task delayed 10 seconds. It's similar to the thread slip, but now we are using the new model for task await. Asynchronous procedure in C# return a task. Task is an object that has all the information that we need to know the status of the the status of the operation. In the case that is a long time operation, that is asynchronous. We use this method here, and as you see, we put before the await. What's meaning that? Well, when we execute that, the method created the task and return immediately the task to the system. In the case that we don't use await, they continues to execute here. But because we are using await here, the system return the task and also go to the end of the procedure and return the control to the program. And these two instructions are executed only when the task is returned as finished. We can see this one. If you wish run the program, we can see here asynchronous synchronization. And now we made the same. We will invoke this method using the event of this button. If you click the button, now you see that this works. And also the interface is continues to be responsive. But the task is not finished. It's a long time of it. Now it's finished. Let's see in detail what happened in the previous example when we use asynchronous operation with task away. In that case, when we click the button, the event in the same manner that the synchronic operation called the associated method. But now, when it begins to execute the long time operation, the method execute long job async return immediately a task object. Because the task object is received by a way operation, the program reacts as following. One, the control go to the end of the procedure, returning to the main tray the control, and second, the two last instructions of the event are not executed until the task is finished. These two instructions are also executed asynchronously. Observe that the execute long sync operation is named with determination assigned by convention. Besides, to use array in C method, you must to declare it as assigned, and to maintain consistency, also finishes as assigned. That is all for now. In the next build, we will demonstrate how to run two tasks in parallel. Thank you.